Hey everyone, I am here to show you guys a slow flow. So I've made a playlist, it's on Spotify. It's called Slow Flow 4-3 Breathe. If you have Spotify, awesome. Make sure you get a premium account, pay for it so you don't have the commercials and crossfade your songs all the way through at the most level that they can crossfade. So we're gonna get started on our mats. So grab a mat, find your sacred space of whatever you wanna make for yourself, and we will get started. Starting at the top of your mat, start to take some last ending stretches throughout your body. Start to find a comfortable seat on the mat. Wiggle out your tailbone, your bottom, so your tailbone is grounded on the mat here. We're going to go through some neck rolls. Then start to find a neutral spine here. Take your hands on top of your knees. Chin level with the floor. And start to notice just anything here about your body or about yourself. Dealing with your physical body, emotional, spiritual, intellectual. Just start to pay attention to one of them or all of them. Notice how you're feeling. Your left hand to your heart, and your right hand right in front of your face, with your palm facing towards you. Start to breathe in and out through your nose here fluidly. Feeling the air come out through your nose. Feeling it on the palm of your hand. Notice how it's cooling here. And then switch. Right hand on the heart, left hand in front of your face, right in front of your mouth. And start to take a deep inhale through your nose and fill up through your stomach and expand as big as you can, like a balloon. And then open your mouth, exhale throughout your mouth like you're fogging up a mirror, and squeeze your belly button towards your spine. Deep inhale, fill up again. Exhale, open mouth, breathe it out. Again, inhale, fill all the way up through your ribs and your collarbones. Open your mouth, really feel that breath come out through the back of your throat. And then take both of your hands down into your lap, seal your lips closed, and notice your breath with the same intensity in and out through your nose. Keep breathing like this while I'm talking. And just notice the lower muscles that are engaging
through your pelvis and through your lower abs here. Imagine you're sucking in and squeezing in your Kegels up into your stomach at your Uddiyana Bandha. Activating your Mula Bandha, feeling a tight squeeze through your muscles here. And it's okay to let go of it a little bit through your inhale, and you'll feel a big squeeze belly towards your spine on your exhale. And just take your breath a couple more times and start to notice your breath about a 4 second to 5 second inhale and a 4 to 5 second exhale. You can keep this breath with you for however long of a practice of what you need today. You can keep your breath 4 to 5 seconds or 6 seconds or even a little bit shorter. Just notice your breath always moving in and out through your nose here. And try to close your eyes throughout as most of the practice as you can. On your next inhale, start to raise your arms all the way up towards the sky. Let your head lean back a little bit. On your exhale, take a twist over to the right side, left hand on the outside of your right knee, right hand by your hip. Look tall over your right shoulder. Still see if you can keep your eyes closed here. Nice and tall spine. Take another inhale and exhale here. And then start to lean all the way down towards the center of your mat, still holding your knee here. Start to take your forearm down to the ground and raise your right arm all the way up and over your ear and feel the stretch to the side of your ribs here. Keeping your elbow on the inside of your front knee. It's okay if it doesn't go all the way down to the ground. Inhale, come all the way back up and full exhale. Take that twist over the shoulder. Inhale, raise your arms all the way up towards the sky. Exhale, twist to the other side. Right hand on the outside of your left knee. Feel that pull. Take your left hand right by your hip. Come up over your left shoulder. Take another inhale and exhale here through your nose, always. On your next exhale, start to lean down towards the middle of your mat. Take your forearm down to the middle and reach your left arm all the way up and over your ear, still keeping your hips grounded here. If your hips come up, don't go as far with your hand or your fold. Inhale, come all the way back up. Full exhale, take the twist, look over your shoulder. Start to cue your music for yourself. Inhale, raise arms all the way up. Exhale, take a twist to the right. Inhale and exhale, lean down towards the middle. Inhale, right arm up. Inhale, come up. Exhale, twist. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale, twist to the left. Exhale, take that fold. Left arm reaches over. Inhale up. Exhale, twist. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, twist to the right. We're going to keep these movements. Just go at your own pace. You can go as slow or as fast as you want. Thank you. Raise your arms all the way up towards the sky. Exhale, take your hands down to the mat, and you're going to scoot yourself back. Find your tabletop. Start to wiggle out to your bottom. Find star hands right underneath your shoulders and knees underneath your hips. Start to make circles with your bottom towards your heels and come all the way up. Take your circle in the opposite direction. Come back to the center of your mat. Wiggle it out. Make sure that your hands are still underneath your shoulders and your knees are hip-width apart underneath your hips. Exhale, round through your spine. Find the calf back. Really raise through your shoulders here. You can find fingertips on the mat and have your bottom come towards your heels just another inch or two. Inhale, press your hands into the mat, lower your belly, look forward, tilt your hips up. You can even tuck the toes here if you like. Exhale, round through your spine, find that calf back. And start to move fluidly through your cats and cows, however you like. Inhale, cow. Exhale, calf back. Maybe even find those circles throughout these movements. Start to find another different child's pose and see if it feels better for your body. This is a stretch for your hips and your legs. Maybe take your knees together, bottom back towards your heels, and reach your arms back behind you, right by your legs with your palms turned up, and feel a stretch through your lower back here. Let your neck hang heavy. Maybe massage your third eye, rock it left and right, and if this doesn't feel good, go back to the previous child's pose. All the way back to the front. Take your hands to the front of the mat if they're not already there. Start to come back up into your tabletop and knees come out hip width apart. Tuck the toes and raise up your knees about an inch or two off the mat again. On your next inhale, start to twist your feet over to turning your toes to the right side and having your bottom come towards your heels into a little stretch. Look underneath your right armpit. Inhale, come back to the center into your low hovering tabletop. Exhale, twist your feet over to the left side. Inhale and exhale, bottom come towards your heels. Look underneath your left armpit. Inhale to the center, exhale, twist to the right. Inhale to the center, exhale, twist to the left. And then start to move again fluidly with your body. Just take it about four more times. Go as fast or as slow as you want. Two more. And tuck your toes, raise your hips, find your downward facing dog. Start to press your heels into the mat. Feel your hands press into the mat. Shoulders press back away from the ears. Shake out your head here and look past your thighs. Start to pedal out your feet here. Maybe both feet at the same time. And slowly start to tiptoe your feet up towards the top of your mat. Feet come hip width distance apart. Grab opposite elbows. Hang into your ragdoll. Left and right. And bend through your knees here. Come to the center. Turn toes forward, straighten your legs a little bit more. Left hand stays down, bend your left knee. Inhale, right arm up towards the sky, look up. Have a little pulse through your left knee. Exhale, right hand down. Inhale, left arm up, bend through your right knee. Find a little pulse here through your right knee. Exhale, take your left hand down to the ground. Find a flat back, hands hover above the ground or on your shins or your thighs. Squeeze your shoulder blades back away from the ears, looking down in front of your toes. Exhale, take that fold. Inhale, slowly rise all the way up. Inhale, arms reach up towards the sky. Feel your fingertips press together like a gun and feel your arms squeeze your ears here. Exhale, round through your spine. Find a cat back here as you stand, chin towards your chest. Inhale, rise all the way up. Take a back bend here if it feels good. Exhale, round through your spine again. Cat back. Inhale, open back up. Exhale, cat back. Two more. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale, take a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, press your hands down. Step your feet back behind you. Start to find your plank. Start to twist your feet over to the right side. Make sure your left hand is underneath your left shoulder. Inhale, right arm up towards the sky. Look up. Maybe take some hip dips here. Really raise up through your hips here. Exhale, press your right hand down. Twist your feet over towards the left. Inhale, left arm up towards the sky. Pulse through your hips. Exhale, press your hands down to the mat. Have your knees come down to the mat and point your toes up towards the sky. Make sure your hands are underneath your shoulders again and press your body weight forward. Exhale, squeeze elbows in tight to match the rib cage and then press it back up. And we're we're going to take little chaturanga modified push-ups about 5 times. If you want it, take it. If you don't want it, you don't have to. And on your 5th one, exhale all the way down, lower down onto your belly. Start to have your feet come back up towards the sky and have them come through either side of your mat, massaging your thighs. Turn your cheek to one side and rest. Start to press the tops of your toes or your feet onto the mat and take your forearms out in front of you, shoulders in line with your elbows. Press your palms onto the floor, finding your sphinx here. Lifting up through your heart and your chest, look up. And then slowly let your neck hang happy. Take some neck rolls here, any way how you like them. And then come back to a neutral position. Start to slide your hands underneath your shoulders. Squeeze your elbows in tight and find a little baby cobra here. Lift up through your heart and your chest. You can always go back to the previous pose if this does not feel good. Press through your toes on the mat. Inhale, straighten your arms all the way up. Finding full cobra here. If you want it to get more difficult, you can raise your knees and your thighs off the mat and even tuck your toes into an up dog. Exhale, bottom comes up towards the sky, press your heels into the ground and pedal out your feet here. If your heels are not pressing into the ground, walk them up towards your hands a little bit more until they press and your bottom will lift up higher. Shake out your head. Pedal out your feet. Remember to breathe in and out through your nose here. We're going to start to take that a couple more times. You can either step up or jump up towards the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, roll up, go slow. Arms up high, find the fingertips. Exhale, round through your spine, find that cat back. Inhale, all the way up for a back bend. Take it a couple more times. One more. Find a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands down, and we're gonna break down our jump back. If you're ever gonna jump back through your vinyasa, press through your hands, light on your toes. You're gonna jump your feet back in ending position is your chaturanga. If you didn't get it, you can step your feet back to plank. Press and shift your weight forward. Exhale, elbows in tight. Inhale, scoop your heart open. If you want to rest your knees and thighs, you can. Exhale, tuck toes, raise hips, downward facing dog. Shake it out. Remember to take 3 deep breaths here. Start to move with your body. Go at your own pace and your flow. I'll guide you through one last time. Step up or jump up. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise. Exhale, cat back. Inhale, back fold. Take it 5 times. Exhale, fold. Inhale halfway, exhale, flow through your vinyasa, high plank to chaturanga. Inhale, cobra, up dog, exhale, down dog. Take it on your own, last time through. Adding in or taking out anything that feels better or you want to take away. Start to move through your vinyasa. We'll meet in a downward facing dog. Step up or jump up towards the top of your mat. Feet come together. Start to bend your knees. Lower your bottom just a little bit back, keeping your knees in line with your ankles here. Lift up through your heart and your chest. Have a smile on your face. Take your left hand out in front of you and your right arm back behind you. Look past your right shoulder. Inhale, switch. Right hand in front of you. Exhale, left hand back behind you. Inhale, both arms come out in front of you. Find the tippy toes here. Press your heels down. Find toes up towards the sky. Exhale, take a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, press your hands down to the mat. Start to take your left foot back behind you. Lower down your back knee. Make sure your front knee is in line with your ankle and press up onto your front knee. If this feels good, you can always stay down towards the center of your mat if you want. On your next inhale, raise your arms all the way up towards the sky. Take a small back bend. Exhale, take a twist. Left hand in front of you and right hand back behind you. Look past your right fingertips. Exhale, left hand comes down to the inside of your front foot. Inhale, right arm up towards the sky. Look up. You can even tuck your back toe and raise your back knee for a full dragonfly twist. If you want that bind, wrap your right arm behind your lower back. Look up. Inhale, right arm back up towards the sky. Exhale, take your hand down on the inside of your right foot. Lower down your back knee and inch out your toes to the right side of your mat. You can stay right here. Maybe inch back your back leg, still resting the top of your foot on the mat, and try to lower down onto your left forearm. Take your right hand and press out your right knee. Open up your hips, look over your right shoulder. You can feel your left hip come down to the mat if it feels good, and your right arch comes up a bit. Let your neck hang heavy if it feels good, or look over the right shoulder. Inhale, come back towards the center. Start to press both of your hands on the mat. Heel toe your right foot back to the center. Start to take your right hand underneath your right leg. Walk your left hand back so that your hands are like push-up hands, about shoulder width distance. Tuck your back toe and raise your back knee and start to rock your body forwards and backwards here. We're gonna break down an arm balance, so we've already gotten here, which is pretty far. You can always go back to the previous position and work on the previous pose anytime. On your next exhale, you're gonna feel the back of your thigh rest on the back of your bicep here, the back of your arm, and your arm creates a tabletop top. So bending your arms as much as you can like a tabletop and squeeze your left elbow towards your left hip as your right leg starts to kick out to the side. Maybe look towards your right toes to find that drishti in your gaze help you. Pointing both toes up, active feet. And then press the back foot to the mat. Come back to your mat. Heel toe your right foot back to the middle. Bring the back knee down to the ground. And find your fists on the ground. Take another inhale and exhale here. Take both of your hands to the mat. And step your right foot back. Find your downward facing dog. Shake out your head, pedal out your feet again. Step up or jump up towards the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. You can have your feet hip width apart or you can keep your feet together here. Just hang here and bend your knees a little bit and take some wrist rolls. Take your hands to the mat and fingertips towards your body. Bending your knees as much as you can. Start to lift up the tops of your toes and your palms underneath your feet. Toes towards your wrists as much as you can. Making sure that your feet are hip width apart here. Just making sure again, I told y'all to move. Keeping this bind here, inhale, halfway lift, peek up. Exhale, bend your elbows out wide, look past your thighs and try and straighten your legs a little bit more. Take five deep breaths here. Fifth breath, slowly release your binds. Have your fingertips face each other, bend your knees a little bit, and rock your body left and right very slowly and gently. Inhale, take a halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Heel toe your feet back together if you can for your chair pose or keep them where they are. Knees stay in line with your ankles, bottom comes back a bit, find your chair pose, hands at heart center. Exhale, right arm back behind you, left arm in front of you, look back past it. Inhale to the center, right hand out, left hand back behind you, look past your left shoulder. Inhale, left hand comes back out in front of you, find your tippy toes, heels off of the mat. Exhale, press your heels down, toes come up. Exhale, forward fold. Leave your left foot into the ground. Start to take your right foot back behind you. Lower down your back knee. You can inch it back further here if you want a deeper stretch with your legs. You can stay right here, come up to your front knee. Woo. Make sure you're breathing in and out through your nose. On your next inhale, start to raise your arms all the way up towards the sky. Maybe take a small back bend here if it feels good. Exhale, take a twist, right hand in front of you and left hand back behind you. Look past your fingertips. Exhale, take your right hand down to the ground. Inhale, left arm up towards the sky for your easy twist. Tuck your back toe and raise your back knee and thigh off of the mat. Full expression. And you can take a half bind to your left arm behind your back. Maybe hold your right hip. Still look up past your left shoulder. Making sure this whole time that your front knee is in line with your ankle. Inhale, left arm up towards the sky. Exhale, press your hand on the inside of your left foot. Lower down your back knee and heel toe your foot out to the edge of the mat. So Start to lower down if it feels good onto your right arm. Feel your hips opening up here. Notice where the sensations are happening in your body. Draw attention to them. Take your left hand on your left knee. Press out your left knee. Look over your left shoulder. Maybe your right hip comes closer to the mat and your left arch comes up. Look over your left shoulder. Come back towards the center. Press your left hand back to your mat, heel toe, your left foot onto your mat. Make sure that it's still in line with your knee. Working on our arm balance here, you can stay right here. Or you can lean all the way down as far as you can. Take your left hand underneath your left leg. The back of your leg is going to rest on the back of your arm, and you're creating a tabletop for your leg for this arm balance. Take your right hand back so that your hands are in one line like a push-up. You're going to start to tuck your back toe and raise your back knee off of the mat, and you're going to rock your body weight forwards and backwards. Start to create some momentum here, maybe just the beginning of your arm balance. On your next exhale, start to squeeze your right elbow towards your right rib or your hip, and your left leg comes out to the side. Point both toes up towards the sky. Look past your left toes. Breathe in and out through your nose here. Exhale, press your left foot down and your back foot to the mat. Heel toe your left foot. Come back to the center, find fists on the mat, strong through your wrists. Take your left hand on the other side of your left foot. On your next exhale, find your downward facing dog, left foot comes back. Pedal it out, shake it out. Still breathe in and out through your nose here. You're going to step up or jump up towards the top of your mat with your feet out wide into your malasana yogi squats. Press your hands at heart center, shoulders back and away from your ears. You can always sit on a block here or two blocks. On your next exhale, take your left hand out towards the left side. So keeping your elbow and your knee connected. Inhale, right arm up towards the sky. Look up past your right fingertips. If you want to take your full bind, right arm behind your lower back for half. You can grab a towel or a strap and take your left hand around your front left leg. Find your fingertips or find your strap. Squeeze. Look over your right shoulder still, opening your heart. Still breathing in and out through your nose. Starting to find a balance here. Heel toe your right foot into the center and your left foot. Find a drishti, a listless gaze. Start to look up. You're going to straighten your right leg as much as you can, still finding your bind. If you don't have your bind here, wrap your left arm underneath your left leg. Finding your left tippy toes on your next inhale, start to rise up. See if you can challenge your gaze to look over your right shoulder. You can even take tree pose or just a leg out. Exhale, take your left foot down to the ground. Find your malasana squat again. Hands at heart center. Take an inhale and an exhale. Hands press down to the mat. Turn your toes forward. Find a forward fold. Heel toe your feet out to the edge of your mat and bend your knees and grab opposite elbows and hang them to your Make a figure eight. Stretch out your lower back and the back of your legs. Preparing ourselves for the other side. Come to the center, take your hands down to the mat, heel toe your feet back to your mat, and find your malasana yogi squat, heels in, toes out. You can play with it here. Try and press your heels into the ground. If it doesn't feel good, that's okay. Press your hands at your heart center again. Lift up through your heart and your chest, always here. Nice and tall spine. Take your right hand out to the right side, still keeping it on the inside of your right knee. On your next inhale, left arm comes up towards the sky. Look up. Take your left hand behind your lower back for half bind or full bind, malasana, right arm around the front bent leg, towel or strap or fingertips. Look over your left shoulder. Start to heel toe your left foot to the middle of the mat. Heel toe your right foot to the middle of the mat, right next to your left. Find your right tippy toes. Again, if you don't have this pose, wrap your right arm underneath your right leg. On your next inhale, remember to find your drishti, your listless gaze. Rise up. Open your heart and your chest. See if you can challenge the gaze to the left. Exhale, take it down slow. Unbind, right hand down. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Turn toes forward, find a forward fold. Walk your hands left and right side of your feet. And slowly lower down all the way onto your bottom. Have your legs come out in front of you. Find a boat pose. Navasana. Lift up through your heart and your chest here. You can always take the hands to the mat if you need it. You can have bent legs or straight legs. Just remember to lift up through your heart and your chest. Nice and tall spine always. Slowly start to take your feet out in front of you. Lower and hover your chest back. Your lower core. Inhale, come back up. We're going to take it again. Exhale, start to take it out. Squeeze, still breathe in and out through your nose. Three, two, one. Bring it back up. Last time. Slowly start to hover. Don't let your shoulders touch. Don't let your ankles touch. Start to lower down as far as you can without letting your shoulders or your ankles touch. And then take a full body stretch. Arms come over your head. Maybe take some ankle rolls and some wrist rolls. Hug and squeeze in your knees towards your chest and take little rolls here. Circles with the knees. Take a butterfly pose, soles of your feet together, and hold your ankles in towards the inside of your legs. Shoulders down and back away from your ears. You're going to start to rock your body with some momentum to come up to the top of your mat or any way to come up there. And notice the placement of your ankles naturally. Wherever they are, it is best for your body. If you want them closer in, you'll feel a stretch on the inside of your legs, or if you like them out further, you'll feel a stretch through the outside of your legs. Inhale your arms all the way up towards the sky. Look up. Exhale, take your hands out in front of you as far as you can. And slowly take your hands down to the mat in your forearms. You can rest your hands on blocks here and let your neck hang heavy, or you can rest your head on the block. Noticing the energy that is still coursing through your body, and noticing where you have felt stretches, your ligaments pulled, inhale, roll up real slow. Trying to keep your eyes closed here as much as you can. On your next exhale, take a twist to the right side, outside. Left hand holds the outside of your right knee. Right hand by your hip, look over your right shoulder or gaze. Remember, as we just did before in the beginning, start to lean your left arm all the way down to the middle and right arm stretches up and over. Notice the difference here. Inhale, come back up and exhale, find your twist. Inhale, arms reach up towards the sky. Exhale, twist to the left. Hold the outside of your left knee. Left hand by your hip, gaze over the left shoulder. Exhale, lean down towards the middle of your mat, still holding your knee. Take your left arm up and over your ear. Feel your shoulder pull out and away. Inhale, come back up. Exhale for your full twist again. Inhale, come back towards the center. Have the soles of your feet come to the mat, bending your knees. Lower down onto your back, vertebrae by vertebrae. And lift up your right leg towards the sky. Take an ankle roll. Cross your right ankle over your left thigh. And take your right hand and press out your right knee to feel your hips come out of your ribs. You can stay right here. If you want to take it further, take your right hand in the hold and left hand, both hands grab the underneath of your left thigh. Hug and squeeze in towards your chest. Pressing your shoulders down onto the mat. And your pelvis. If you want to take it further, notice if your hips are lifting, if your bottom is lifting and your shoulders are lifting, don't go any further. And remember that you're your best teacher always, whatever feels good. On your next inhale, lift up your left leg towards the sky, take your hands out from the hole and grab the back of your calf, your ankle, or grab with a peace finger your left big toe with your left hand. So keeping your shoulders as much grounded to the floor as you can. Pulling your left leg towards your chest. You can bend your elbows out wide to have your leg come towards your nose more. You can always use a strap or a towel here too. If your left leg is straight up towards the sky, start to bend your left knee again and hold and hug in your left thigh. If you're here, everybody start to press your left foot into the ground. Take your right hand and press out your right knee. Take both arms all the way out to the side of your body. Cross your right leg over your left leg so that the knees are almost kissing. And knees twist towards the left side as your head turns to the right. It's okay if your knees don't touch the floor, and you can also use a block here. Remembering to notice the different sensations through your different bodies. Inhale, come back towards the center. Press left foot into the ground. Inhale, right leg up towards the sky. Take another ankle roll and press your right foot into the ground. Inhale, left leg up towards the sky. Take an ankle roll. Cross your leg over your right thigh, figure four. Left hand, press out your left knee. Stay right here, take it further, hugging your right thigh towards your chest. Pressing your hips and shoulders to the ground. Further, if you want to extend your right leg and grab up there. Your leg is straight up. Bend your right knee and hug in your right thigh. Press your right foot into the ground. Press up your left knee again for your figure four. Cross your left leg over your right, arms to a T, twist your knees to the right side, and head to the left. Inhale, come back towards the center. Press your right foot into the ground and left leg up towards the sky. Press both of your feet into the ground as close to your glutes as you can and hands by your hips. Lift up your hips towards the sky. Open them up. Exhale, lower down. Any other stretch that you would like to do with your body to end your practice tonight, just do whatever feels good to your body and start to find different sensations that you like. When you're ready, start to come into your savasana, your deep resting pose. Traditionally, you can lay down on the mat with your legs out to the edges of your mat. Arms to the side of your body, palms up, open to receive. If you need your knees bent here so it doesn't hurt your lower back, you can do that. Or lay on your side or tummy. Finding stillness within your physical body. and noticing deep inner feelings that have been opened up, or what you want to open up. Closing your eyes and noticing a natural breath in and out through your nose, lowering your heart rate. Relax your jaw. Maybe the lips come undone. Relaxing the tongue off of the roof of your mouth. To notice the colors behind your eyes. You're welcome to stay here for as long as you like and pause the video. If you're ready to wake up, start to deepen your breath. Wiggle your fingers and your toes. Roll your wrists and your ankles. Full body stretch. You can bend your knees and move them left and right. Turn to the side of your body, fetal position, arm as a pillow. Keeping your eyes closed, slowly start to sit up. Easy Sukhasana seats. Take your hands on top of your knees. Chin level with the floor and shoulders down your back. All of your different bodies, physical, spiritual, emotional, and intellectual appreciation for combining all into one. Inhale your arms all the way up towards the sky. Let your head drop back slightly, breathing in all of the light and the great energy that you have created for yourself here. Lead it all down to your heart center. Remember that you are the brightest light, and you are supposed to shine as bright as you can, encouraging and spreading your love with others. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste. Thank you all for joining Slow Flow with me. Take your time on your mat for as long as you need, because I have yoga brain and you probably do too. So drink some water, take some more rest and time for yourself to reflect. Maybe take some time to meditate. And I hope you all enjoy this video. Let me know any comments or feedback. See you next time.